City Council, Trevor Kostanich. Dwayne Williamson was unable to attend today. We have council member David Cook, Brendan Elwood, Judy Belanco, Martin Vulcan. And for the uncontested race of position number one, council member Jonathan Rosen. You are now each invited to make an opening statement of 1 minute each. And we will start with Mayor Ewing.
Thank you, Steve. And thank you for the members of the chamber. Thanks for having me here. I'm Ken Herring. I'm running for re-election as mayor of North Bend. I have 12 years as a small town mayor, and I have 25 years as a business owner. But big question is, what made me qualified to be mayor 12 years ago? 12 years ago, I had already spent time on two different advisory committees at the behest of two different mayors. I had 5 years on the Planning Commission, where I learned about the Growth Management Act, I learned about development regulations, I learned about the comprehensive plan. I learned that we were not always in charge of our own destiny. I spent many evenings, most Tuesday evenings for 4 years, sitting in the council chambers watching the council members work, learning the issues, learning the process, learning how to be a mayor. So clearly, that work should have made me qualified to be mayor, but sadly, it's such a huge learning curve that even that didn't do it justice. I will conclude my comments.
Hello, everybody. Thank you. This is a lovely time to be here. Appreciate you all out there. My name is Mary Miller. I've lived in the Valley for 23 years. I have two children, a 17-year-old daughter and a 21-year-old son, both seniors. I guess that makes me a freshman, actually, because I'm new to this. I'm going to be very blunt and very open about that. The last time I was doing anything in politics, which was back when I was a senior in high school. So there's a huge gap. I'm 55, so there's a huge gap in years. It doesn't lessen the fact that I care and feel deeply, deeply about the community I've been fortunate enough to live in the region that we are currently in. The Suquamish Valley is a remarkable place, a place of beauty and just amazing amounts of community love, and I want to help support that. So the job of stepping into mayor is absolutely astronomically huge. I expect that it would be more of a full-time position, and I'd be willing to carry that on. I'm a professional photographer for the last 20 years. I've had my own business for the last 10, so thank you. Thank you very much.
Hello, thank you, Steve, the Chamber, and the Suquamish Valley Record for putting this event together for us all to outreach more, get to hear more from candidates. My name is Trevor Kostanich. I'm running for North Bend City Council, position number 3. And I chose to run primarily, I believe, that our city is at a real critical point right now with how we manage the growth. Coming at us, we have roughly 800 new dwelling units in the next few years in North Bend, and we can only expect that demand to continue. I think the growth is an awesome opportunity for us to better improve existing infrastructure and also help us support a more vibrant downtown. So I feel qualified to serve on our council. I've got a civil engineering degree. I've worked directly in the planning industry the last 15 years. More recently, I've served on the North Bend Economic Development Commission for the last 4 years, where I've been a big proponent of pushing for strategic growth, primarily in revitalizing our downtown. I'm sadly disappointed that Dee didn't show up today so I could explain more of my issues, but look forward to sharing what I can at the closing statement and encouraging people to reach out after this forum. Thank you.
Hi, thank you all for coming out for lunch today. My name is David Cook. I'm on position number 5 of the City of North Bend Council. I have been your representative now for 12 years. I was elected in 2003 and elected 2 times after that. I have 2 kids, 12 and 6, in the school district, and I live right in the downtown of North Bend. The reason I'm running for council for a 4th term is I'm very concerned about managing the growth that North Bend is experiencing and how it affects our traffic congestion, our roads and infrastructure, and in particular our downtown revitalization efforts. And so I'm looking forward to having this discussion and telling you what my positions are on various things. And I thank you for allowing me to be here today. Hello, I'm Brendan Elwood. I'm running for position number 5 as well. And it's interesting in thinking about how I should construct this particular introduction, I realize that there's a lot of you that don't really know who I am. I have been serving on the Siview Metropolitan Parks District Commission for a number of years now, as well as the North Bend Planning Commission. And the reason why I chose those two particular posts is that if you want to understand the true character and charm and the culture of the community, those two particular commissions are where it's at. From the Planning Commission side, you learn all about policy, the resources, and things that are really true challenges to making the city work. When it comes to the Park District, what's great about that is you are in touch with the people. There's constant communication. You're able to understand their needs, wants, and desires. And so I think in that respect, I'd like to point out three distinctions between myself and my opponent. The first and foremost is that I passionately believe, that we need to preserve and enhance North Bend's charm and character. That's something that has been lost along the way. The second thing is, we need to reach back out to the public. We need to have them involved with our decision-making process. It is absolutely vital that they buy into what we're doing. After all, why are we here? That too is something else that has been lost over time. My third point is, some of these people have been here for 12 years. It's time for new change. And no wonder some of these things are lost. Let's get back in touch. We need to re-engage, refresh, and revitalize.
I'm Judy Belanco, and I'm running for position number 7. I'm not sure what year it was that North Bend resident Betty Vaughn forgot to close the gates, but whatever year that was, my family made it through and established their roots in North Bend. I was raised in North Bend, and I graduated from Mount Si High School. After graduation, I left to earn my college degree. I worked for the city of Wenatchee, and then I spent 15 years on the mortgage side of banking. And that was an interesting 15 years. That was in the Bellevue area. I'm glad to be home, and I want to be part of the future of my city. I want to maintain North Bend's charm and pedestrian scale, and our independent businesses, funkiness, engaging populace, and I truly treasure the world-class beauty which surrounds us. I love North Bend for what it is. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Martin Vulcan, and I'm running for position number 7, because of three things. There's a lot of talk about like what the town should be like and what it shouldn't be like, but in theory, we actually agreed upon this several years ago. I was part of the Economic Development Commission when we concluded a brand audit for this town, and much to nobody's surprise, we decided that North Bend should be an outdoor town. That's one of the reasons why I would like to be a part of the city council, because I think I'm uniquely qualified to actually implement this brand. I have spent my entire adult life and professional life in the outdoor industry. I've owned a retail store in North Bend for 15 years. I own an international mountain guiding office. I'm a product developer for the outdoor industry. I'm a risk management consultant. And so no matter which way you turn it, I work in the outdoor industry. I think I can help implement the brand. And I also have done business in downtown North Bend for so long that I've experienced a very firsthand how far from the potential that downtown North Bend is right now. We have got to revitalize North Bend. I want to do this in order to do two things. I want to live North Bend up to its potential, A, and I would like to ultimately create a highly livable small town. And I think North Bend has more potential than anybody else.
Hi there. My name is Jonathan Rosen. I'm running for position number 1. Fortunately, I didn't know I was going to be up here today, so my remarks are not well prepared, so I'm just going to have to kind of wing it. I've been living in the Valley for about 17 years. I have 2 children here, 10 and 13. Between them, I've gotten heavily involved in the Little League, so some of you may know me from that area instead of from the city council. Before that, I was from the East Coast. I actually went to school back in Washington, D.C. and took a course and a major in political science, which both my parents constantly reminded me wouldn't lead to nothing, but here I am today using my degree finally. So I've served 2 terms, and during those 2 terms I've had, I think, some things that I'm really proud of and some accomplishments. and none of those accomplishments would have occurred without my fellow council members and our city staff. Oftentimes we talk about ourselves, but we forget that we have a phenomenal staff in the city of North Bend, and I'm sure Snoqualmie has the same. Some of those things that we've done as a city, we've stayed focused on infrastructure, public safety. Public safety specifically, we've changed our police contract. We've moved over to Snoqualmie, and in doing so, we have not only increased the level of service, but we've reduced our costs. Our parks are in the midst of a major transformation. Over the next couple of years, you'll see almost $1 million put into Ferguson and E.J. Roberts Parks. I've worked hard on constituent outreach. I think I've done a fairly good job working with our fellow citizens and being available, and I will continue to do that. One of our earlier accomplishments as a city is we got the water moratorium lifted, which is just huge. I don't think anyone really understands how big that was to our city at the time. I've had the pleasure of serving as the finance chairman for several years, and during those times, I've worked hard to steer the city through some of the most difficult financial times I think this country's ever seen. And we've managed to stay balanced with our budget, and we've managed to keep our reserves intact, which many cities could not accomplish during those times. Last but not least, I'll talk about one of the things I probably have a great sense of pride is I worked hard during my first term on affordable housing, and we developed a cottage zone, which now that we have our water and the economy's turned around, we should start to see get developed. Hopefully, it will develop the way we envisioned it. But that is certainly something I've worked hard on, and I have a great sense of pride. And other than that, I thank you for having me here tonight, or today.
So, pass the microphone all the way back down. We'll start on this end again. Trevor, you're gonna answer the questions too, right?
It depends on your time and what you want.
No, we want you to have the opportunity to just take your... All right, we'll start. So we'll alternate the who answers first, like we do with Snoqualmie. It'll make more sense with this size crowd. We'll start with Mayor Herring, and nope, I lied. We will start with Candidate Miller. And we'll start with what do you see as the most critical issue facing North Bend, and how will you address it?
Most definitely, we have growth coming at us at a hyperspeed, I would say. So we have traffic congestion, we have a lot of problems with the infrastructure. We have to attend to that as soon as possible and get really on it. Otherwise, we're going backwards, which I hate to see. This town deserves to be explored in every possible positive manner. It's a place that we want to have people come to stay, enjoy, and thrive in. And the businesses that are in the downtown corridor are at risk as well if we don't get a handle on this. So this one is a hot topic for me.
You can pass it to your left. We'll work to the left, and then we'll start around.
Thank you. Yeah, the growth management is definitely the hot topic in North Bend. It's been a while since we've seen this percentage of growth coming at us. Through the primary, when I talked to a lot of citizens, the bigger concern amongst the community definitely seems to be traffic. And you know, I think that we have an opportunity to be proactive in handling mobility. We know there's a lot of new travel trips added to our streets through a combination of coordinating our transportation improvement plan with developer impact fees. We can be early on implementing these improvements, so we actually have the capacity prior to when all the new homes and residents are there. And one thing that I'd like to share, in addition to vehicular mobility, I'm actually a big proponent of improving our non-motorized mobility in North Bend. And what I mean by non-motorized is really our trail network. You know, we are an outdoor town, and we have a real decent trail network, decent city parks today. You know, as Jonathan hinted, we're gonna see a lot of improvement in our city parks, and we're really close to adding a lot of great connectivity. And I'd love to see us, as the new developments come in, we're actually requiring neighborhoods to add that mobility link for that trail to get to an existing trail, downtown, our businesses, and our schools.
One of the myths that's out there floating around North Bend is that somehow North Bend wants to grow and become an Issaquah. And the city was very careful a long time ago to not allow that to happen. When the Growth Management Act first came on the scene in 1990-91, they wanted North Bend to grow by more than 5,000 homes. And the city fathers back then negotiated that down to a number of 1,590. So our required growth is 1,590, of which we are roughly halfway there. Between 2012 and 2031, we have to grow 649 more homes. We don't have a choice. We can't put up a wall and say we're not going to grow because the state will, you know, sue with the city into oblivion and cut us off from some funds and services of the state. So we're mandated to have that growth. And what we're seeing now is a lot of, now that growth has started after a long moratorium, it's causing traffic impacts. And we have some solutions already going into place to deal with the growth and deal with traffic, which we'll get into more later. This is an interesting topic, because there are a lot of things that are happening right now. There are a lot of critical issues. I think, first and foremost, dealing with growth. I mean, Olympia is pressuring us hard. There's a lot of pressure coming down to manage growth. They're mandating how we need to do it. Otherwise, they will cut off funds for our community. But when I start looking at the spirit of our town and what's really going on, what I'm finding is a critical issue is that we've lost the public's trust. I'm going door to door every weekend. And here's essentially the three things that I find. People have no idea what's going on, but they don't like it. Second thing is, they have somewhat of an idea of what's going on, and they don't like it. The third thing is, they just found out what's going on, and they hate it. So this is why I contend, back to my original elements of all of our decision making, we have to make sure that we're preserving and accentuating all that North Bend has to offer. We have fantastic outdoor resources. We have all these great people. But we've totally got lost in the shuffle. We are out of touch with not only our citizens, but with our local business owners, which is my other key component. We have to have those two solid before we can even start thinking about what we're going to do with our community. And unfortunately, that's been the problem. There hasn't been much thinking about our community.
Have you guys ever had an employee that you didn't have the courage to fire? And then you started restructuring your business around that employee? Well, that's what's going on in downtown. You know, so we're talking about like banners and flowers. There's a couple of, you know, property owners there that are just unwilling to keep up their properties. That's like sort of like a bad employee. And well, you know, in every company will ultimately have like a bad employee, and then you can start complaining about that person. But at some point, if you don't do anything about it, it's not that bad employee's problem anymore. And I think we have been talking around this particular issue literally for 20 years. There are buildings that are vacant, and I could tell you guys stories of the condition of the interior of these buildings for 25 years. That's not a way to run downtown. That doesn't stimulate the economy. It's really, I just don't think it's a bad way to be. And in terms of like condemning people, I want to make sure to say it's a last resort. It's not something that I'm in favor of, because where does that stop? But what we need is have some sort of like a minimum maintenance requirement that is not just some sort of like a policy written somewhere in the rules. It needs to be enforced.
So acquire downtown properties through a modest bond, and I'm assuming he means a voted bond, which would mean 60% approval, which would be an uphill battle to begin with. I want to say first off, we need to expand our vision of downtown. It's not just the historic buildings in two blocks. It goes two blocks to the south and two blocks to the north, and along both east and west outside that historic zone. We need to focus our efforts on the whole downtown core. Granted, we have some eyesore buildings. They are owned by people who refuse to do anything with them. And how do you wrestle those buildings away from those people to work for any purpose if they don't want it, if they want to hang on to it? I agree, we need to do something about their minimum maintenance, but we cannot force them, nor will I, try to force them to put tenants in their building. That's called property rights. I do not believe that we have the right to tell them what to do.
This is quite an issue, isn't it? It's a huge one. And I've been listening to each one of you, and it's been very fascinating and enlightening. I want you all to know that I'm a person of the people. That's what I consider myself first and foremost. So when I talk about the city and the structures that are falling apart, you're all saying the same thing, mostly. The family that owns that building, he came right up to me directly and said, I will work with you. You know, I don't know what to say other than, huh, why? So there's lots of problems here. We've got to really work together. I hope, as mayor, I would want directly to be having a crew of people, council members. I'd like the city staff to be definitely a part of it. I think the staff of the city right now is actually very, very good. Londi's doing an excellent job. I appreciate that. And bring the people together. We have to bring these people back to us because they're running. And they're upset. And it's unfortunate because we have an amazing town that's just dying. It's going to die if we don't help. So thank you very much.
So that brings us to the let's move to the quick yes no rapid fire section. Please indicate your answer with a hand raise. If you're in support of this of the item, raise your hand. And if not, keep your hand down. Within the city limits, would you support homeless shelters? Within the city limits, would you support a marijuana shop? Within the city limits, would you support a tattoo parlor? Within the city limits, would you support additional roundabouts? Excellent. So this will bring us to our next poll question, which is on traffic, speaking of roundabouts. And I believe it is Councilmember Cook's turn to start. The traffic infrastructure in North Bend has not kept pace with new development, and the city is anticipating 800 more new homes. What would be your plan for dealing with increased traffic congestion?
Well, what you need to understand about traffic is that the city has no money to mitigate the impact of growth until we get our impact fees. One, the city council is going to raise those fees up. Right now it's roughly $5,000, it's going to go up to $10,000 or more. We don't get those impact fees until the building permit has been submitted, or the application has been submitted. At that point, we're going to gather about $9 to $10 million. That money is enough money, along with other funds that we have access to, grants and other city funds, to fix what I call the mess in front of QFC. It's going to be kind of an oval about. I don't think it's quite a roundabout, but it basically fixes all of the ingress and egress of the roads going right around QFC. It'll be enough to fix Ballarat, which my wife will be very grateful for, because for 17 years it's been rated as a D or an F intersection. We'll be able to fix Tanner, Thrasher, 140th, and Exit 34. So that's the big message I want people to understand, is that we have plans in place now to fix all of these traffic congestion issues.
You know, it's funny when you ask that question. I was thinking of this word association game that you play. Like, you say a word and I say whatever comes to mind. And when I hear traffic, the word that came to mind, quagmire. That's what we have downtown, is a quagmire. Now, I like the fact that we're going to let development pay for development, and there are impact fees coming in eventually. But Mr. Hearing here brought up a good point. If we're going to start seeking other additional revenue sources, such as a bond, for example, we're going to need 60% voter approval on those things, something I'm totally familiar with, because I've led the bond initiatives at Sideview Metropolitan Parks District. And every time we go out and ask the voters for our district, will you continue to support our levy? Will you support us in this bond? We get 60 to 70% approval every time. I know the city council would not be able to get that. The mayor is right, we wouldn't. And the reason is, we're out of touch with them. So we have to figure that out. Now, I do like development, paying for development, but the fact of the matter is, we have to look for additional revenue sources.
I was just talking with the financial director of North Bend the other day, and she is explaining to me how all the grant funds are starting to evaporate. So that we're in a definite pickle here.
Well, I'm not quite sure what I can add to that. I think David has explained that pretty well, where our funds come from. I know that there was some thought given to maybe not perhaps raising the traffic impact fees, but I totally support that. I think we need absolutely every dollar that we can get for the growth pay for growth, and we absolutely will get some of them solved. I don't know about when the grant funds freeze up. I'm not quite sure. Sometimes they freeze up, open back up, depends on what we want to do on that. But it is a huge issue, and we do have to solve it, and so we're going to be a step in the right direction. I understand what David is saying, that we don't get those funds until those housing permits are issued. And I know it sounds, a lot of people think the minute it, you know, you apply for the thing and it gets approved, that you've got the money. You don't. You don't have the money until the house really is done and sold. So it does take a little bit. Thank you.
Well, I hope the transportation improvement plan is as crystallized as the growth plans for the housing. And I didn't read the entire transportation improvement plan because it's really dry. It's pretty painful reading. But when I read over it or skimmed through it, it didn't look to me. There was a lot of vague language in there, and I'm hoping that we can use this time that it takes to build these houses to fully crystallize the transportation improvement plan, because I don't think we're quite there yet. But so that's my hope for that.
So traffic has not kept pace with growth. The first thing I want to talk about is the collection of the transportation impact fee. The legislature just recently adopted a new rule, thanks to the developers' lobbyists. We don't get to collect that impact fee at building permit anymore. We have to wait till it's being occupied before we get to collect that. That's another 3 to 4 month lag in getting that money. So please call your legislatures and tell them you don't like that idea, because that's really hard for the cities. Besides that, has growth not kept pace with or excuse me, traffic improvements not kept pace with growth? I think Mr. Cook mentioned it, that he mentioned it in regards to the Ballarat intersection. It was already a level of service F before growth happened. So in certain cases, we can force developers to pay for improvements if their development has a direct impact on a particular intersection or a particular piece of road. But if that roadway is already at a below level of service C, I believe it is, maybe it's D, but if it's below the acceptable levels, we can't force them to do it. We have to pay for it with the impact fees or our own money.
The question is about the traffic infrastructure in North Bend not keeping pace with new development and participating in their new homes. What is your plan for dealing with increased congestion?
Thank you. Back to that. My understanding is that we were looking up towards 1,500 homes. Is there a conclusive answer? Anyone know about that? A total, 1,500. So I think on a spectrum of that kind of amount of homes coming our way, we have to really get going on this. And that takes time, that's the thing. So we've lost grants here, we're going back for another larger grant, I understand that's to be the case, to help support the plazas coming in. That's where we're headed right now. I believe that's to be the case. But the traffic is just, it's just an abomination. And I when I go out and meet the people, all I'm hearing is this, the report back is, what do? You know, and the people are not feeling like they're heard. Here's another situation. So there's growing frustration everywhere around. So we've got some big issues at hand for sure.
Next question. Next question is about affordable housing. Do you believe that the city should be encouraging or excluding affordable housing, such as Habitat for Humanity or Imagine Housing or other providers, or you prefer a more market solution?
I definitely agree that we need to be exploring this on every level, whether it be Habitat for Humanity, whether it be on the market level. We have a wide variety of people that live in North Bend, all coming from different backgrounds, different economic resources, and those type of things. And one thing that really troubles me is that we have people in our community that have lived there their whole lives. They work there, but they can't live there. In fact, the other day at the block party, this is how alarming it gets. The other day at the block party, I was talking to folks, and this lady came up to me, and she's now homeless. She's working in North Bend, trying to raise her family, living out of her van. Now that's ridiculous. That's absolutely ridiculous. We have to explore every possibility under the sun for affordable housing. Absolutely, without uncertainty.
I think when the affordable housing first came on everybody's radar, there was a project that came up, and it's called cottage housing. There are two plans that I'm aware of for cottage housing in North Bend. I think one of them has been scaled back a bit. It's the Ranger Station cottage housing development. I believe it is down to maybe 60 homes, maybe perhaps 55. And the one on Cedar Falls Way, I think that's probably around 40. So we do have some in the works, but I really don't know if indeed that will pan out as far as what we consider affordable housing. I'm a little bit worried about that. I'm hoping that we can get some condos built, perhaps some of our apartments built, and I know that has to be zoned, but it will provide some housing. I think we have some opportunity, and I think we need to explore that. It certainly should be on our plans. Thank you.
Yes, I think it should be part of the greater plan for the North Bend City build out, because I think it's part of our social responsibility. I don't think not everybody can do well. And there's some people who maybe are a little bit less fortunate. And I don't see North Bend as a community that then starts to effectively eliminate people who are maybe not quite so lucky. So I think it should be part of the greater plan for the city build out.
Affordable housing. A few years ago, a developer came to me and asked if there was some way we could put together this cottage idea. And his idea was houses of 1,200 square feet or less with detached garages on 10 units to the acre, and where they would be market driven in price for the entire time of their life. No government involvement. I thought that was perfect. We ended up with a product in that where the smallest would be around 950 and they would go up to about 1,200 square feet, two bedrooms, maybe three, one bath, market driven. Great idea. And all of a sudden, another developer says, well, I can't build that. I need 3,000 square feet on that same lot. That's not affordable. That's not gonna be affordable. I bring it that way because a friend of mine just moved over to Spokane, and he's involved in a cottage housing program up there where the maximum house size is 950, and they are selling market-driven like hotcakes. It can be done, market-driven.
Yeah, I think there is a definite need for apartments. We need a few more structures out in North Bend to help facilitate people that keep having to find another way to get to town to go do their work. There's a lot of people that I've talked to over the last few months, even the years, I'll say, that are feeling like they're being pushed out of town. And there's some rough reasons behind that. Some of them have become homeless. Some of them are striving to get back into a home. But we need more apartments on that level. When I say more, I wouldn't say 200. I would say a smaller, maybe 20, 25, something to get us started, so we can have a fuller reach for people who just don't make the money that some of us out here do. We need to have that available, so I'm open-minded to all that. That's part of our plan for the future, I hope.
Yeah, affordable housing, it's a tricky issue. There's a lot of these issues today that I think us smaller towns here in the Upper Valley, we're fortunate to go learn from the Seattles, the Issaquahs, what they did right or wrong. This is not one you want to go learn from Seattle right now. Seattle is struggling with affordable housing, as are lots of places. And it's a tricky issue. I think the market-driven thing, I'd love to see that work, Ken. I think it's you're not going to find a lot of developers that are able to do that unless the city is going to maybe accommodate a much higher zoning, a much higher density, because right now that is the challenge with North Bend is the market is driving it really high, and that's without some of these improvements that everyone at the table wants to do. So I think we have to get creative. I'm very open to utilizing some existing programs that have shown success, whether that's Habitat for Humanity, and really trying to sit down with these developers and figure out a way that it is going to work, because in other words, a for-profit development is going to have a hard time making this pencil. Thanks.
The city council has just struggled with the idea of affordable housing, and for a number of reasons. We did do the cottage housing, and we thought that was a good idea. We were told these new houses are going to be priced in the range of small houses. You know, single moms could move into them, firefighters, school teachers. But then as time goes on, we figure out that the market's going to drive those same prices up to 400. They're not going to be affordable. It's not going to solve the problem. And then some of those lands during the recession were bought up by people that have no intent to develop them in the first place. 25% of our cottage housing zone is never going to be developed because they're going to be held on to as just future investment. So what do you do? How do you go about getting affordable housing? Do you want apartments? Apartments can solve it to some degree, but apartments serve the city no benefit to build up our infrastructure because you don't get any excise taxes from apartments. The only way you get excise taxes to invest in your city is from fee simple or individual homes like the cottage housing. And I'm getting flagged again, but it's a very complicated issue. And the city will continue to struggle for it because we don't have the land necessary to have enough of it to make an impact. And so our attempts, unfortunately, are very feeble.
So let's move on to our closing statements. This is your opportunity to tie up one of your subjects that you've touched on already, or just tell us, give us another reason or two why you are the right pick.
You ready? Okay. When I was doorbelling and introducing myself to folks, one of our residents and I started talking. She said to me, "Do you know what North Bend is racing to be?" And I thought maybe I knew the answer, but it was her time, so I certainly wasn't going to say anything. And so she said, "I'll tell you what we're racing to be. We're racing to be a knockoff of Issaquah." And she says, "We don't want to be a knockoff of Issaquah. Promise me that you don't want that either." Well, I don't want that either. Choices are not always about dollars and cents. It's oftentimes about a quality of life. I love my city, it's my hometown, and I love its vibes. I want to be a part of the decision making that will determine its future. If elected, I will be present, prepared, and at the table to do this. My only agenda is the betterment of the city and to serve all the citizens of North Bend. And I do ask for your vote on November 4th. Thank you.
Yeah, well, I ask for your vote too. Because I think North Bend truly has the potential to be the coolest town on the western slopes of the Washington Cascades. I just don't think anybody is as, and no town here is as uniquely positioned. It has sort of like all the right potential, has all the right problems right now with growth pressure, but I think we can turn those growth pressures into a positive thing. What I would like to say though is that I hear very often is like, well, we can't do this because the state tells us that, or we can't do that because no builder wants to build this, and we can't do that because then the funds dry up over here. I mean, I guess if I had lived my life like that, I would have never shown up in America because everybody told me that that was a stupid idea when I left Switzerland. And trying to make a living as a mountain guy, well, then maybe that was a dumb idea. But
But I think we need to have the courage to sort of decide who we want to be when we grow up. And I know that that's not necessarily the easy road, but I think there are ways on how we can do that. And I think that's what it's going to take in order for us to actually integrate the agreed upon brand and make North Bend truly let it live up to its potential. Thank you.
We're doing close
up. Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm supposed to get to, I don't know. Thank you. You know, sometimes people said to me, why do you want to serve again? And, obviously you take a moment, you pause, and think about that. And I have to say something that probably you rarely would hear from a politician, but I love my job. I absolutely love being on city council. I love working with citizens and fellow council members and staff. I love working hard to find compromises and solutions. And that's something that your council always has to do, because we all have so many different competing interests that we have to listen to all the time. I love working to improve my city. And I think the most important thing is, what I love most about my job is, I love working hard to leave something behind for my children and all of our kids. And that drives me all the time. I want to have something that we leave behind as a city that we're all proud of. I look forward in the future to working with any of the new council members, and I've said to all of them before, and I'll say again, I'm here to help. Anything you need or any questions, I'm always available. And that goes to everyone in the city. I respectfully ask for your vote. And in addition, thank you so much for allowing me to do something I absolutely love.
Conclusion. Well, I led the city through the last 5 years of a 10-year development moratorium, added on to by 2 years of the Great Recession. Terrible time to be leading the city. We survived. We balanced the budget. I presented balanced budgets to the city council every time, every year. And I never thought once to dip into reserves. It is in my blood. I bring to the table a conservative fiscal approach to budgeting and finance, and that's what's required of somebody who's running a small business or a small city. I want to thank the chamber members for their ongoing support. Appreciate that, a lot of years of support. I ask for your vote. I am the right person to be mayor of North Bend.
Thank you, everybody. I ask for your vote. I am a supporter of the town I love so much. I've never lived anywhere longer than I have in North Bend. I love the people here. I'm community driven. I want to help everybody. It's going to take time. It's a huge learning experience for me. I'm willing to take that step. I already have by just putting myself in as a write-in. There's a long story to that, but the reason why I was a write-in is because it's a big job. I realize that, but there's a lot more that I don't realize that's going to be contained in it. My children are very important to me, of course, but they were the ones that said and had to give my 100% vote was from them to step forward this way. So with that being said, I think there's exciting times to be in front of us, and I think the council members here and the gentleman and Judy right there are all fabulous individuals with lots of great ideas, and I think we just have to reach far and forward into the future to help support what we know can be good and great in this town. So it's going to take a while. Thank you very much. I ask for your support.
Well, it's really neat to be up here with the amount of passion that's here, because obviously I think, I thank everyone who's served, and it's been just an awesome experience for me to learn more about the town and more what the people want. I think we're all just real fortunate to live in such an amazing area, and why, these are great problems to have. So I'll just kind of conclude with, some more of my passion as to, why I'm running, and really kind of want to share the strengths that I look forward to bringing to strategic planning, and especially the mobility and the revitalizing of downtown. I'm definitely excited to continue to help in any way, with smart planning, smart implementation to just continue to make North Bend a really, really exceptional outdoor town to live in. So thanks again, Steve, the Chamber, everyone for your time and allowing us to share more words and hear more thoughts from each other. Appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you, Chamber, for running this forum. It was really good to be here. You know, I love this job. I've had the honor to be your councilman for 12 years now. And, you know, there's a lot of big issues on the table. I want to help the city get through some of these things with the smartness that we've gotten through the recession and the water moratorium. We've had a rough, rough road the last decade. But, you know, I heard the comment that the city's lost its charm and character tonight. And I can't disagree with that any more strongly. We have the coolest town on the east side. Every time we have a public forum or an event, people come out in droves. People love to live in North Bend. And it's a neat, neat city that people care about each other, people love each other. When the floods happened, everyone was out there filling sandbags, helping our neighbors. We have a very special place, and a special place that needs to be protected. And you know, sometimes it's the little things. Sometimes it's, you know, someone comes to you and says, hey, I need help with this street, or I've got this pothole. And this job is about making a difference in people's lives and caring about our neighbor and making everything better for the whole community. And I hope to continue to be your councilman in 2016, and I ask you for your support. Thank you very much.
Thank you as well. This is a great honor to be here talking with you guys today and covering some really critical issues that are facing our community. I still go back to what I said before. There's been some decisions made in our city that are lacking some fundamental values. Those values are, quite frankly, striving to preserve and accentuate North Bend's charm and character. I think it's been lost over time. I agree with Martin. I'm hearing constant can't, barrier, barrier, barrier. But I think that's just an artifact of time. The second thing we need to do is clearly look for other revenue sources. But in addition to that, we have to get back in touch with our public. We've lost that trust. We've lost that connectivity. That's another key value to all the decisions we make. But that's been lost over time. So I'd like to just wrap up by saying I think those are the critical areas that we need to really focus on if we're going to get any more traction with moving forward with our community at all. It's absolutely vital that we stay in touch with the community and we bring them along on the journey. It's absolutely vital. I recommend the city take the foot off the gas pedal right now and we sit here and we analyze what we have. We have tremendous resources. And as you said, we have great people, neighbors coming out to help one another. That's fantastic. We're losing sight of that as a city function. A city council is losing touch of that and we need to bring that back. We absolutely need to bring them along the journey. Thank you.
Again?
Oh. Well, it was so great. I want to hear it again.
I should also add, if you can't get enough of North Bend politics, we will have our excellence on October 7th at 6 p.m. at the North Bend Theater, we will have another forum specifically for North Bend candidates. That should be a lot of fun. I would like to thank...
How much are tickets?
The popcorn is $20 at Plant. I would like to thank Michaela and Holly, for our excellent AV assistants from the high school. Going to post the video of all of this online, so you can't get enough, you'll be able to share it with your friends. I'd also like to thank specifically Carolyn Simpson, who is on our school board, and so as an elected official for that, she had another meeting she had to be at today, but she prepared the scripts and gathered the questions and really put a lot of work into it, so she's not here, but let's thank her anyway. And also Andy Gladden, the president of the board, who's been working his tail off. Every single slide that you guys saw, Andy was a huge part of what's gone wrong this summer and this year. So thank you, Andy. And our member services boss in charge, our red card gal.
Kaylee. Thanks all that stuff.
Let's thank Kaylee for. If you have any questions about the gala, you can come and ask me about them while I eat lunch. And thank you all for coming.